Welcome to London. My name's Andy Alder and I'm the programme director for Jacobs on the Thames Tideway Tunnel programme. So as you see behind me, this is the River Thames that runs right through the heart of the city of London. It's a fantastic place, you know, right in the middle of one of the world's greatest cities. But there is a problem. Like many old cities around the world, most of London is served by a combined sewage system, which collects not just the sewage from the toilets, the sinks, the showers, the washing machines, but also the rainwater runoff from the roads, the gutters and pavement, hence the combined system. The magnificent system we rely on today was designed by Sir Joseph Bazalgette after the Great Stink of 1858. There were over 300 million bricks used to construct over 1,000 miles of underground sewers, and these are still in brilliant condition, but they're simply overwhelmed by the volume of sewage based on today's population. London's sewage network was designed and built when there was around 2 million people living in London. Now there's close to 10 million people living in London. There's a lot more hard paving than there was previously. And when the rains come, particularly those intense sort of short storms, the sewage system doesn't have the capacity to cope. It's in brilliant condition, but it just doesn't have the capacity. So it overflows into the river at various points called combined sewer overflows. And at these points, there's something like 40 million tonnes of untreated sewage getting discharged into the River Thames every year. And obviously that's a major problem. From an environmental wildlife point of view, it affects the ecosystem in the river, it takes the oxygen away, it kills fish and it destroys other wildlife. From a public health point of view, it's a public health hazard for people who live, work and have leisure activities in and around the river. And from an aesthetic point of view, it's obviously just not a great thing to have, you know, raw sewage going into the river in, as I say, one of the world's greatest cities. And that's where we come in. So the Thames Tideway Tunnel programme is what we call London's new super sewer. We're building a 25 kilometre long super sewer tunnel under the Thames to intercept all those sewer flows and clean up the river for the good of the city, for its wildlife and for its people. It's a deep level, large diameter sewer system which we're tunnelling from Acton in the very far west of the city, 25 kilometres of tunnel which runs right through the River Thames and eventually connects down into the sewage treatment plant at Beckton. We have 21 sites, like the one at Victoria Embankment just behind me here, where we're building deep shafts. When we complete, we'll connect the sewer network down into our deep tunnel so that if those rains come, when those rains come, the sewage system, if it reaches capacity, can overflow into our structures, down our shafts, into the tunnel, and the sewage can be safely taken away down to the sewage treatment plant and keeping over 95% of the sewage overflows out of the river, providing a better environment for the wildlife and a better environment for the people who live and work in the city. There are two separate connection tunnels, one that's 4.6 kilometres long and one that's 1.1 kilometres long. At its widest point, the main tunnel will have an internal diameter of 7.2 metres. That's enough to fit three double-decker buses across the width of our tunnel. The tunnel needs to fall at 1 metre for every 790 metres so it can be self-cleaning. So it basically runs on a constant gradient from about 30 metres deep in the west to about 66 metres deep in the east at the end of the project. It's really important on projects like this to work with our communities and give back to our communities. And one of the things we've done here is our approach to employment. We've created lots of opportunities for employment of local people, for creating apprenticeships, for young people to join the project. We've worked to bring people who've had, you know, kind of difficult start to their life, such as ex-offenders, to bring them into the project and give opportunities, and also to create an inclusive work environment where people from every type of background can come and work on the project, you know, be part of the team and contribute the, you know, their very best to what we're doing. Reducing our carbon footprint has been a key element of our legacy programme. Through the planning stage, we reduced the carbon footprint by 35% through selection of the route and the overall scheme design of the project. And we continue to work with our supply chain to reduce the carbon, the embodied carbon, in all of the elements of the work that we're building. The river itself has been used to transport construction materials. And by using the river, we've taken an estimated 500,000 lorry movements off of London's roads to date. With clearly important health and safety, sustainability, environmental and air pollution benefits. Completion is expected in early 2025, at which point we'd have fully commissioned the system. It's really empowering when you work with a client who shares the same cultural values as we do at Jacobs. From the outset, Tideway has created an inclusive workplace and culture and has had a really strong commitment to inclusion and diversity throughout our team. And it's been brilliant to work alongside Tideway to really drive that into the work we're doing. Tideway has been recognised for a number of initiatives, including establishing a returners programme, specially designed PPE for male and female employees, including things like maternity PPE and modesty PPE. And we've got some really engaged and enthusiastic employee networks for gender parity, racial equality, LGBT, and for ability action. The primary purpose of the tunnel is to reduce the sewer overflows into the River Thames and improve its water quality. But beyond that, our vision is to reconnect London with the River Thames. It's an ambitious statement of intent and reflects our desire to deliver wider benefits to London for years to come. The scale of the project and its place at the heart of one of the world's greatest cities means we have a historic opportunity to leave a lasting legacy here for London.